exactly dressed for travel?
No, I'm not going anywhere.
You could still fly home with Carly and Sean.
No, we already talked about this.
Well, Franco has dropped out of sight. No one's seen him since the hotel lobby in Toronto, and that was about 12 hours ago.
Okay. Well, I mean, how many times has Franco disappeared without a trace? He does this and he vanishes for months. Why would this be any different?
There's no guarantee Franco won't show up. Maybe I should go to Toronto and talk to the art dealer and just, you know, follow up on whatever he gives me.
Okay, well, how long is that going to take?
I don't know.
Well, can I come with you?
I need to handle this alone.
Okay. Then you have to realize how important it is for us to spend some time together now. I mean, I get it. I understand you're gonna have to deal with Franco. You have to understand that I need some time with my husband first.
I really don't want to leave you.
I know. And if that happens, I'll deal with it. All that matters is neither of us are leaving today.
When you guys heading to the airport?
How soon?
You know, it's not too late for you and Sam to change your minds and come home with us.
Need any help?
Yeah, you and Jason can come back to Port Charles.
Absolutely not.
Why?
Why?
What's so important about this honeymoon that you're willing to make Jason a target for Franco?
I did not make Jason a target for Franco. He did that all on his own. I realize he is the threat.
If you realize he's a threat, then why aren't you taking it seriously?
Oh, my God. Carly, do you really want to talk about what's going on here right now? Jason is trying to set boundaries with you. Yes, he told you to come to him in case of emergency. This is an emergency, but let's be honest. This is your excuse to show up here.
An excuse because I fear for my daughter's life.
You have Sean looking after you and your daughter.
I don't want Jason to come back to Port Charles to take care of me and Jocelyn. I want Jason in Port Charles so he has the advantage in case Franco shows up, Sam.
What if he doesn't show up, Carly?
Jason and I don't want to live our lives looking over our shoulders or worrying about the next move. We want to be able to be free. Yeah, and I've been where you are. It's called denial. Franco's not going to stop being a threat because you want him to.
Well, then Jason and I will deal with that.
Is that what he told you? Jason wants you to help him deal with Franco?
He is my husband. Yes, I will help him if he needs me,
not your husband. You know what? But he's also my friend. And we both know that Franco tortures Jason by going after the people he loves, Sam. And we both know that Franco won't stop.
Okay, I want to make sure you're available to stay in Port Charles indefinitely.
I'm not sure I'm ready to talk long-term employment.
Sean, I got to end this Franco thing. And that means I'm going to have to go after him.
When?
Man, I haven't decided. Probably sooner than later, and I don't know how long it's going to take, but I need to know that things are being handled while I'm gone.
Not sure how cooperative Sonny's going to be.
No, I'm not worried about Sonny. I'm worried about Carly and her kids, and I need to know that you're going to look after them for me.
Okay. I won't consider the job done until Franco's been dealt with. Good enough?
Appreciate that.
Everything okay in here?
How much longer is this honeymoon gonna last?
We're only here a couple more days.
Then you're coming home.
That's kind of open-ended.
You're going after Franco.
Yeah, we should get going. It's gonna take us forever to check all these bags and get through security.
Why? I need you to do something for me, okay?
Anything.
I need you to listen to Sean. If he tells you to do something to keep you and your kids safe, you need to do it.
Okay. Then I need you to do something for me. Can you do that?
I can try.
Can you be careful? Okay. Say goodbye to Sam, sweetie. Say bye.
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 Say thank you. Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
And you say goodbye to Jason and you tell him you love him.
Mm.
And you tell him, come home. Soon.
Mommy.
Yeah, mommy's
and have fun with me on the plane.
Thank you for that.
For what?
I know you're only staying for me.
It's our honeymoon. You know, I don't want to give it up any more than you do.
Look, I don't want you to feel bad. You've done really well for a beginner.
You know, actually, to set the record straight, I actually caught more waves than you did.
Okay, so... all right, I have to be honest with you because that's what marriage is about. It's about being honest and truthful. I kind of let you have some of those waves to build up your confidence.
Oh, so you were going easy on me.
Yeah, right. I didn't want you to be intimidated.
Let's make a deal.
Okay.
Let's just enjoy the water.
Mm-hmm.
And not surf at all.
No!
What?
I love watching you surf.
No, you love watching me fall.
No, it's not about the fall. It's about... you laughing after you fall. You always get out of the water laughing, and I never see you laugh.
That's
and
right.
Actually, to be honest with you, the only time I fall is watching you fall because I'm laughing at you laughing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to have to catch more waves than you.
No. Wait! Oh, wait for me! I'm trying to be charming. I'm so going to beat you!